Guys, I recently visited my mom for Mother's Day, and while I was there, I learned that she really, really, really is obsessed with patchouli like I am. She's a patch ho. Well, while I was there, day after day, she was wearing different fragrances, and I was saying, God, that smells great. What are you wearing? It's this one. God, that smells great. What are you wearing? It's this one. So I went through the collection with her, her own collection, and we figured out that she has her favorite fragrances, and she also has her favorite patchouli fragrances. So in this video, I'm going to talk to you about her favorite patchouli fragrances that I discussed with her, and we rank them together from her least favorite to her most favorite. So if you want to find out what they are, then please stay tuned. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Sebastian with Smelling Great Fragrance Reviews. Yes, today I'm talking about my mom's favorite patchouli fragrances. And I guess my mom didn't really know of such a thing as patchouli until I guess she started wearing Angel and Coco Mademoiselle. I think those are what really ignited her love for patchouli. And so throughout the years, I've given her fragrances, and some of them do end up having a bigger or dominant note of patchouli, and she kind of gravitates towards those fragrances. And the fact that she also likes long-lasting beast mode fragrances is another thing, because she complains if fragrances do not last. So she tends to gravitate towards the patchouli because patchouli has a lingering power. Either way, today I'm going to let you know about her favorite patchouli fragrances. But before I do, if this is your first time tuning into the channel and you still haven't subscribed, please do click the subscribe button below and also click the bell so that you'll be notified for future videos and giveaways. So how many of you are fans of patchouli? I know you've been watching this channel and you probably think I speak too much about patchouli, but it is one of my favorite notes. Absolutely love it. And I think the reason I like it is because not only does it smell sexy, but it does have lingering qualities, like it lasts a long time. And some of these fragrances over others have a longer lasting power, but we're going to go ahead and get started right off the bat. Now, this one I gave to her as soon as I discovered it towards the middle part of 2019. It's a less expensive fragrance from the house of Yves Rocher. This is Nouveau Genre. So I gave her this one because they generally have sales on the Yves Rocher website. It's a 50% off sale. This is 100 ml for about 80 some dollars, and discounted, it was about 40 some dollars. So I bought a couple of the fragrances from this collection to gift her. But she really likes this one, but she's ranked it low because she doesn't think it lasts as long as some of the others. And we do have some beastly fragrances here, but she likes the fact that this is a little more simplistic than others, but she still has, you know, it still has that patchouli smell that she likes. This is created by Marie Salamagna, and it features notes of patchouli and tonka beans. That's what they credit. And you know, it does wear like that. It's a simplistic fragrance, but one that actually does linger on. It's that whole patchouli, the earthiness, the woodiness, the sparkliness that kind of lingers on, and it'll stay on your skin. And if you're calm and you're not moving around, you know, it's not going to have that projection. But once your body heats up a little bit when you're moving around, and people, you know, will smell your cloud, your trail, and things like that. So that's what I like about patchouli fragrances. Obviously, it seems like she does too. But this, she's ranked this one kind of low because it's not as intense as some of the other ones in her collection. But she says she likes the way it smells. And when she's going to be working with a lot of people, she kind of pulls for the lighter fragrances. Either way, Yves Rocher, Nouveau Genre. Check it out if you don't know it. That house has some great fragrances. Sadly, they don't have any physical stores in the USA. At least I haven't seen them. But if you ever go to their website, the USA website, you can order things when they have them on sale. As I said, they have 50% off sales occasionally, and it's a great deal to get some of their fragrances. I have a whole video on three of their fragrances. Go catch that video. So the next fragrance my mom likes, it's number five in her list, is Montal's Black Oud. Now, this is not necessarily known for a lot of patchouli, but it has a pretty prominent patchouli presence. presence here, but it's mostly about the rose with the oud, and then of course patchouli comes in as well, and she likes this combination. She likes the oud and the rose here. She really likes rosy fragrances, but I think what really does it for her here is the patchouli, the fact that it's long-lasting, it's intense, but it's kind of ranked a little low. The reason is because it's not the biggest patchouli fragrance. That's why it's at number 5. But she likes the fact that it is a very long-lasting fragrance, and she seems to gravitate towards the beast mode fragrances. She doesn't really use that terminology, but the more intense fragrances. And I really do like this one from Montal. It's a top-notch release. It's another fragrance that I recently featured in a lingering, longest-lingering fragrances video. And I think that if you like long-lasting fragrances with the oud and a rose and the patchouli together, this is definitely one that you should try. And I think this is definitely one of the better niche offerings of that whole combination, the oud and rose, and then throwing in that patchouli as that extra sexy layer to the fragrance that I really, really like. So that's Montal's Black Oud. If you don't know it, do check it out. A really, really great scent from Montal. The next fragrance she ranked at number 4 is from the house of Mugler, and it's Angel Muse. Now, I gave this to her some years ago, probably around 2016, after I fell in love with it, and the fact that I knew she loves Angel, the original, I thought she was going to like this. And even though she loves the way it smells, she complains that it doesn't last as long on her, which I have heard from some people as well. But this one features notes of patchouli, vetiver, hazelnut spread, pink pepper, and grapefruit. And you know, I really love the smell. It's got the chocolatey, hazelnutty thing happening like Nutella in there, but the patchouli is definitely prominent. It has an earthy, grassy, woodiness of the vetiver in here as well, and you know, some citrusy touches and some spices thrown in. It doesn't act as overly complex as the original Angel, but you know, you get some additional layers in here of other things, because there is a little bit of a nuttiness from the hazelnut spread in here. There is you know, a little zingy spiciness from the grapefruit and things like that. So you know, it's a solid release, and I do agree with her, it doesn't have as long of a lasting power as the original does, but a lot of designer fragrances these days are created in a way that they're not going to last too long, sadly. But overall, I think it's a great smell, and she's ranked this at number 4. So that's Mugler's Angel Muse. The next fragrance is from the house of Chanel. This is Coco Mademoiselle. And I gave this one to her probably towards the end of the 2000s. She really likes the earthiness of the patchouli here. And she likes the fact that it's not necessarily an angel, you know, the angel fragrance that she really loves. But then again, it kind of reminds her of that because of its earthiness and the fact that it has loads of patchouli in it. But if you don't know this fragrance, definitely check it out. It's got some fruitiness, it's got some rosiness, of course, some citrusy touches, but I really love the patchouli in here. It's very, very earthy. It's also sparkly. It also has notes of orange, grapefruit, vanilla, jasmine, bergamot, musk, and vetiver. Lots going on in this one, and this one seems to be a very popular series in the collection from Chanel. I haven't given her any of the other flankers. I'm sure she would like them, but it's definitely solid release from Chanel. I think the reason that it's so solid is because they have so many flankers of the fragrances. I do have several of the flankers in this series, and I'm going to go ahead and put a video together of the different fragrances in this collection. I probably have 3 or 4 others, so we'll do that one of these days going forward. But I think it's a solid feminine targeted release, and definitely a winner for my mom for having that patchouli note. Now, if I was ranking it against some other patchouli fragrances, I don't think it's the biggest patchouli or the most patchouli in a fragrance, but it's got such a prominent patchouli note in here that I would put it on a list like this. So that's Coco Mademoiselle from the house of Chanel. The next one that she really likes is from the house of Tiziana Terenzi and Ursa. She really loves Tiziana Terenzi. I've given her several fragrances from this house, and she really likes the fact that they're very, very long lasting. And the reason that the Tiziana Terenzi fragrances are really long-lasting is the fact that they're extrait de parfum concentration fragrances. But the thing is also, I did not I gave her Straight to Heaven 1 year, way early in the early 2010s. She liked that fragrance, and she's no longer has it. But when I had discovered this and I knew that she liked that fragrance, I decided to give this to her, but she really loves this one because it is intense. But what I like about Ursa is the fact that there's loads of leather here with dried fruits and patchouli. Also, there's rum, there's LME resin, tobacco, incense, and vetiver. You know, it's a different take on Straight to Heaven, but then again, it's not. It'll remind you of Straight to Heaven, but it does have that very prominent leather note that some people might not like. I've heard some negative things about it. It does get a little animalic from the leather, and I like that because it's a nice change of pace a little bit for being a fan of Straight to Heaven, and the fact that Straight to Heaven seemed a little on the light side after its reformulations. Now we have this beefy version of something like that going in a little animalic direction. So I really like it, and she seems to like it as well. She does like to wear this one on her sweaters and things like that. It's a great winter fragrance for her, she did say. So she likes that about it because it'll linger on her clothes a lot more than her own body. Either way, Ursa from the house of Tiziana Terenzi, a great scent. So it's almost like this is my own collection, but then again, it is kind of my collection. My collection to her were inspired. I mean, her collection, her fragrances were definitely inspired my, collection of fragrances. So makes sense that she would have things that I have. The next fragrance I'm going to talk to you about is from the house of Lena Reeds. It's Patchouli Antique. Check it out here. It's a new bottle. And so I did a video review of this one with Dahlia in the previous bottle. Once again, the fragrance has changed. It was in a graphic floral print bottle like this is now. It was more of a simple bottle, similar label, but they've changed it once again. But I did compare the fragrances as I was at my mom's recently, because I had sent the 30 ml I had of the original bottle to her, and that's kind of how I started smelling her wearing patchouli, because I had just sent that to her. But I've compared them, and they do smell very, very similar. There might be a little bit of a change, a little bit. I'm gonna have to put it to use a little more, but this is one of her favorite patchouli fragrances, the previous version. As discussed in a video with Dahlia, how they have so many different variations of bottles and names and things like that. But Lena Reed's Patchouli Antique is patchouli, benzoin, amber, incense, vanilla, oak moss, cedar. And you know, it's that kind of vanillic, chocolatey, chocolate cakey, kind of resinous, sweet patchouli fragrance. So with all those notes against the patchouli, it kind of gives you like this chocolate cakey experience, which is really, really delicious. And I love patchouli. And this is, like I said, I sent my 30 ml bottle to her, and she was wearing it while I was there. I was smelling it throughout the house. Even I was downstairs and she was upstairs, and I could smell this patchouli coming down and hitting my nose and going, "Oh my God, what are you wearing, Mom?" She says, "It's the new one you gave me." And I'm like, "Oh yes, that smells great." You know, it does smell great. It's a great patchouli. It's a, you know, that kind of patchouli that I like, the Jovoy Psychedelic Reminiscence Patchouli and similar fragrances like that. It's that chocolate cakey, sweet, vanillic, resinous patchouli that I'm obsessed with. And this is definitely capturing it. But this is her number two. And her number one favorite is, of course, the original Mugler Angel. And I first gave her this one late 90s. I gave it to her in the late 90s. When I was starting to smell, you know, the ladies come into the photo lab I worked at while I was going to art school, I'd smell this, with my nose used to the chemicals from the photo processing, and then ladies coming in smelling like angel, I would be like in heaven. That smell was fantastic. And that's kind of why I gave it to her. That's kind of why I became obsessed with this one. I became obsessed with the men's version, Angel Men, which later became Amen, and the whole, you know, patchouli obsession started. But what I like about this one is patchouli, cotton candy, chocolate, caramel, vanilla, honey, red berries, cassis, blackberry, tonka, and amber. And once again, similar to the Chanel, I don't think this is like a patchouli fragrance or patchouli balm, but the prominent note is patchouli, and they're using the patchouli in a way that it's nicely contrasted with all those other notes. And it has an amazing trail, absolutely fantastic trail. It clings on, lingers on, and women walking by wearing this, you can smell it. It really, really can smell it. And if they have sprayed this stuff on their clothes, you're gonna smell it. Like, there's no way escaping this fragrance. And that's kind of what I like about it. And that's what she likes about it. It's her favorite fragrance. Even though, as I said, it's not like this Lena Reid's Patchouli Antique, full-on patchouli, but there's lots of patchouli here, and contrasted with those other notes, it makes for a fantastic fragrance. So that is Mugler's Angel, and I think next year we're going to be celebrating next year. It came out in 92, so next year, 2022, it'll be 30 years of Angel. It's going to be a big celebration for this fragrance because it's become such a, you know, groundbreaking, iconic release. But either way, Mugler Angel is her number one favorite patchouli fragrance, and that's the list for you today. Her favorite patchouli fragrances. She's definitely a patch ho. And she loves wearing patchouli, and I think once again she likes it because it has long lingering power, and she likes her fragrances to be intense. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for tuning in today to watch this video on my mom's favorite patchouli fragrances. If you have any questions or comments, please list below. Please let me know if you're fans of these fragrances, and or if you're curious to check them out. I'd like to find out. Either way, guys, appreciate you tuning in. As I said, please do like this video, please share it. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and I'll be back with more videos very soon. Have a good one. Goodbye.